Our new data type we are going to discuss is the enum data type. Enum is in lowercase. This is just the title, so it's written in mixed case. Let's say I had days of the week starting from Sunday all the way till the coming Saturday. And for each of the day, I want to identify it with a number. So what I can do for that is, I can declare an enum object like this. So I can say enum week underscore day, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, all the way till Saturday. So here you need to understand a few things. This is the enum keyword, all right? And this declares, okay, an enum type of a variable, which has these following states or enumerators. The word enum stands simply for enumeration or a listing. Suppose I tell you, enumerate all the numbers from 1 to 10. So you will start listing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 like that. So what happens here is, internally, the state of Sunday or Sunday will have the value 0. This will have the value integer 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So now what I do is, I have created a model of enum type of data. Then what I'm going to do is, now I'm going to create an actual variable or give life to this weekday variable. So what I do is, I say enum week underscore day, I say day. Now day happens to be a variable of the enum type, which has the same properties as this weekday. Let us say I want to print what is the value contained in Thursday. So according to me, it should be 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So what I'm doing in the main function is, I am declaring enum weekday day. Alright, I am declaring enum weekday day. So day is a variable of the type enum. Now when I say day is equal to Thursday, and if I say printf value of Thursday is percentage %d day, it is going to print 4. It is going to say value of Thursday is 4. So the output is going to be 4. So this should give you an idea about the enum data type. Let's try to do a little more explanation on this enum data type. Now, if you look at the enum data type, okay, enum stands for enumeration. That is simply listing things one after the other. So these are all, you can think of them as individual enumerators or item list. These are known as enumerators, and the value they contain, like 0, 1, 2, are known as state of the enumerated objects. So enums are variables that possess a small range of values. Here if you see, the first value is 0, the last value is going to be 6. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Okay, so they possess a small range of value. These values or states represent integer constants. The advantage of enum is, I have created weekday as my own type of keyword or variable using the enum keyword. The advantage of enum is, it helps to make your code easy to understand or more readable. You may not understand everything about enum I am saying now, but once we end up actually doing a few examples in this course, your understanding of enum is going to be really clear. But you need to have a fair idea of enum data type, because you generally get asked a number of questions as MCQs in your campus placements. Now, there are a few things you need to take here and make an effort to understand. Now, suppose I do something like this, okay? I can say, okay, let me say I have enum, let's say I have a variable called as t1, and I do something like this. I can say a is equal to 5, then I can leave b, c and d like this. So here what happens is, it gives a the value 5, b will automatically take the next value after 5, b will be 6, this will be 7, this will be 8. This is the first part. So what I mean here is, if I fail to give this initial value, suppose I had declared something like this, A, B, C and D. In that case, A would have been 0, B would have been 1, C would have been 2 and D would have been 3. So if you do not give it any value to one of those variables, then it will start taking from 0 to 1 to 3. That's number 1. Suppose what you do is, like here what you have done is, you have given value to one of these enumerators or one of this listed item, but you have not given item values to B and C and D. So what will happen is B will take 1 plus the value of A. So A was 5, so B will be 6, C will be 7 and D will be 8. Now, it is also possible I do something like this. I can say A is equal to 0, B is equal to 0 and C and D. In this case, what will happen is A will take the value 0, B also will take the value 0, C will be 1 and D will be 2. So what it means is, understand three things. Compiler by default starts assigning from 0 as in this case. Now you may choose to assign values only to sum. Like in the case of this, I have assigned values only to A and B. I have not given many values assigned to C and D. So what will the next unassigned fellow take? 1 plus the previous value. So this is 0, this will be 1 and this will be 2. Now it is also possible that you can assign the same values to more than one type of listed item. But the important thing is these values must be in the range of unsigned int starting from 0 to the maximum size of int on that particular machine. Maximum positives unsigned int, not the normal signed int. So this should give you a fair idea of what exactly is an enum type of variable. As we try to do a little problems as we go towards mastering concepts for towards campus placement, we will be doing a number of problems on enum and you will understand it much better. But if you run through this video more than once, I'm sure you will understand everything about the enum data type.